at 31, I had a request to do number 17 coming out of section 2.6. So the directions for this were to factor by grouping. And anytime I want to factor by grouping, oops, let me change colors. Typically what I do is I start with grouping the first two and the last two. You don't have to group the first two and last two. You're more than welcome to try grouping maybe the first and third one. You could also opt to group the first and fourth one, or you could do the second and third one. You have a bunch of options here, but basically you want to group two sets of two together. And I usually start first two, last two. Doesn't always work, but it works often enough that I'm willing to keep going with it. So if I want to group the first two and the last two, what I want to do is take the GCF out of this first pairing and the GCF out of this second pairing. And so if we look at this first pairing of m cubed and m squared, the GCF is m squared, so I'm factoring out the m plus 1. And if we look at this next pairing of negative m and negative 1, you might initially say, well, there's not anything that they have in common. And I could see that, but typically we factor out this negative symbol. All right, now let me just clean this up a little bit. Let me get some of my eraser going here. And I just want to show you that I am keeping in line with math. And what I mean by that is if you were to redistribute this negative sign here, all right, just to show you where I am, if I do negative 1 times positive m, I do get back to negative m. And if I do negative 1 times positive 1, I do get back to negative 1. So I've factored out the negative in going from this second line to this third line. Okay, now again, I'm gonna erase all of this. So what I've ultimately done is I started this problem with four terms. And when I say four terms, it's here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see that those four terms, let me get a different color, are separated by three operators, addition, subtraction, subtraction. All right, now what I've gotten to, because we've now arrived at this line. Now I have two terms. All right, and you might be saying, well, how do you have two terms? Well, if you look here, I only have one math operator. So I have one math operator separating my two terms. All right, where here, again, up top, I had, when I was with the yellow highlighter, I had the three math operators separating my 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. Okay, so again, like I said, we're at this step. Now the thing about these two terms, and I'm gonna put some erasers on there so we can keep looking at this. These two terms have an m plus 1 in common. So what I can do is I can factor that common factor out, right? That common term out. And what am I left with? Well, let me show you. I'm left with m squared and then minus 1. And the minus 1 comes from the fact that there's really a 1 in front of there. And that's where I'm getting this term. And if you don't believe me, let's multiply that back out to make sure you believe it. So I'm going to go m squared minus 1 times m plus 1 is equal to 0. So I'm actually going to go backwards just to show you that that works. I'm going to double distribute. All right, when I say double distribute, that means I'm going to take the m squared and multiply it to the m plus 1. So I'm going to have m squared times m plus 1. And then I'm going to take my second term, or the second term in that binomial, I'm going to take the negative 1 and multiply it to the m plus 1. So I'm going to have minus 1 times m plus 1 is equal to 0. And sure enough, this equation is this equation. So I want you to see, I can take this leap from here down to here. Ooh, that is a ugly looking arrow. Let me erase some of that. All right, oops, I erased too much. What are you going to do? All right, so again, that shows you that I can go from here to here. And then once you get down to this part of the equation, this becomes a perfect square. I factor it out into m minus 1, m plus 1. Don't forget you did have that m plus 1 up there, so I still bring that down. So I ultimately have m minus 1 times m plus 1 quantity squared, and I use the zero product property, so either m minus 1 is equal to 0 or m plus 1 is equal to 0, so these become my two solutions. All right, so I hope that answers number 17. Thanks so much, gang. Bye.